A very good evening to you. Welcome to the People's Republic of Brighton and Hove show here on Latest TV. Thank you so much for joining us. Madeleine, hello, how are you?
I'm good, thank you. How are you doing?
I'm very, very well, thank you. Very excited about today's show. Should we crack on?
Let's. Today, now I'm pretty new to the presenting team, and I believe that our guest has been here before.
He has.
I've heard murmurings of what's going on, and my mouth is salivating at the thought of it. So today, I'm very pleased to announce that we have Comfy from the Spice Circuit. Hello.
Hello.
Hello again. Yes, a returning guest. We like returning guests. Yeah, it makes us feel
like coming back as well.
Perfect. So much has been, you were only here relatively recently, but so much has changed.
Yeah, about 3 months ago, yeah.
So much has changed in that time.
Well, it's like everything happens in months.
Exactly, and we want to hear about all of it. So, what's the first thing you want to, should we start with what's going on with you, the update with your tours?
So the tours, the next tours that we planned on Spice Circuit are in February. Mm-hmm. And recently we had a mention in New York Times Travel Edition.
Wow.
And also to say that we are one of the 7 best chef-led tours in the world.
In the whole world.
Yeah.
That's
so
incredible.
They pick 7 chefs who do these chef-led tours. And it's great because, you know, I'm not a travel agent or a tour operator by profession. So this is just something that I do, food and travel sort of passion. And to get recognized for it by New York Times, I think that's really, really good. Oh. And also just within an year of Spice Circuit, that's really good.
So you've been going a relatively short time, and in that time you've managed to...
Yeah, we're only two tours old by then, yeah.
Wow. That's incredible.
So hoping that more people would come on board and we'll have more tours going as well.
Well, I find that with my friends and kind of seeing Brighton specifically, which is, you know, super foodie, that the whole sort of tourism, travel, food, wine, all the good stuff, all the lovely stuff that kind of makes you feel good has got a lot more popularity over the last 2, 3, 4 years.
Yeah, I think Brighton is the most happening food destination in the whole of UK, I would say, actually. The number of chefs that are here, the number of restaurants, and more than anything else, then the relationship between lots of chefs and how friendly they are, how they support each other, even when it they all come together to support a cause, or, you know, somebody starts something and everybody jumps in even without requesting them. You know, it's just an amazing feeling to be a chef in Brighton.
Fantastic. That's fantastic.
And you're taking that. You're taking that to Sri Lanka, you're also taking that to Kerala.
Kerala, yeah.
With the article in the New York Times, have you found, I know you've owned, so the February tour, that would be number 3?
Yeah, that will be the
that'll
third
be number
tour,
three.
Yeah.
With your previous tours, have you found you've had a sort of an international group of people, or has it mainly been people from the UK?
No, actually it's been more people from America rather than UK, actually.
Amazing.
So now we have inquiries from different parts of the world after New York Times, so we're looking forward to a really good, and also we have returning guests as well, which is quite amazing.
So, well, you know how good a returning guest feels. I certainly do. Fantastic. So when in February is that?
Well, Kerala tour starts from 26th of January to 6th of February.
Yeah.
And then we go on to Sri Lanka from 14th of February to 23rd of February.
Oh, wow. Yeah. This is beautiful destination.
Yeah, I mean, Kerala was supposed to happen now, like right now in October, but recently they have been hit with the devastating floods that 100 years they haven't seen such calamity, and thousands of people have lost their lives. So, which is what Kerala is a state that has influenced me so much to become a chef. So I think it's time for me to do something and give them back. So we started this campaign called Cook for Kerala
Kerala, yes. Yeah. So
that's fantastic.
That's you in partnership with some other restaurants.
Yeah, I've started off with a pop-up in Amsterdam, actually, because that's when it was happening, right when I was in Amsterdam doing a pop-up. And then my friends who work for booking.com, they took it as their private event, and then they raised money, and then booking.com also started raising money. So see how it grows.
That's like incredible.
And then they were doubling the money and sending it back to Red Cross Kerala. At the same time, I came back and did a Kitchens of Kerala supper club in V&H Cafe in Hove, and we raised about £1,000 from that one single night. And now this whole month-long events going around in Boho Gelato, where they where they're doing a Kerala cardamom and coconut vegan ice cream.
Did you bring me some
gelato? I was wondering. I was afraid if they're just gonna sit here and melt in the studio. Like,
no, it wouldn't have made it
but
that far.
Boho Gelato is just around the corner, as well. Social Board, which is just up the road. They're doing a Kerala chicken curry with coconut rice and dal. Also, they're doing a vegan version of it as well, because they're carrying on with what Boho has started, a vegan version of it. Pizza Face is doing a vegan Kerala aubergine masala pizza. Plus they're also doing a chicken one. So they just, everybody started doing like their own takes, because the more they sell, the more money comes into the fundraiser pot. And I'm doing this Friday I'm doing a Cook for Kerala masterclass at Brighton Community Kitchen, and that's sold out as well. So we're going to look,
that's
we're looking at a big amount by the end of this whole thing finishes, you know.
So tell us about your Friday event, your tomorrow event. So that's where I know it's sold out, but tell us a bit about that.
So what I'm trying to do is just pick all these recipes that I loved cooking in Kerala, or like interacted with local chefs on the tours, who have inspired me to put those, bring those recipes back to Brighton and put them in my supper clubs. And people who will be on board tomorrow, they're going to learn how to make these recipes from Kerala at home. Also, there are lots of vegan recipes that are included as well, and seafood, because Kerala has got a beautiful coastline. Apart from that, we'll be also trying our brand new Spice Circuit gin that's going to be hitting the market very soon.
Hello.
You're now making, on top of everything else, you're now making gin.
It's Sarah from Black Down Distillery, who's our local gin maker as well. And she came up, when I was doing a pop-up at Edge, I asked her, Sarah, can you do a cocktail, a spiced gin-based cocktail as a welcome drink? And she's been so kind. So she's actually came up with the whole Spice Circuit gin, infused with spices that I gave her from Kerala.
That's incredible.
And it was such a big hit instantly. And then we said, I think we should just kind of roll this out.
It sounds as though you've got a great range of events kind of covering all different types of people. You know, some people going to more sort of high profile restaurants through to more informal settings as well. Gin is, you know, drink of the moment, isn't
it? Exactly.
Especially in Brighton. That's really fantastic. So just thinking about, I mean, there's lots of floods globally, unfortunately, at the moment.
In Mallorca as well.
Yeah, and we can kind of see that devastation playing out on the news. So the money raised, you say it's going to the Red Cross?
No, the one that we are raising now, what we're going to do is, having said that, I'm going to Kerala in a week's time, just to go. There's a village there which completely got ruined, completely destroyed, and this is a village of handicrafts and handloom weavers. So their looms are their life, and they haven't got them, and they need repairs, they need to rebuild few things and stuff. So I'm going to go and see what exactly do they need with this money, and then once we raise, when I went back in February, take the tour with me, so we all are going to go there and just kind of buy them things that they need, rather than just kind of saying, here is your money, I would like to get involved and help them rebuild that whole village as well.
So it can be more sustainable when you're not there. Everything, if I've had that help to actually build things up again.
Exactly.
To be self-sufficient, that's really important.
And then we might look into other things as well. We just want this to carry on as well. So we might look into rebuilding a school building that's been devastated or something like that. So I'm just going now to find out how best we could use this funds.
Because you're quite well known for sort of using your cooking and your pop-ups for charitable causes. This isn't a new thing for you, is
it? Yeah, and also let's not say a charity, let's say it's a responsibility as a chef, you know.
Amazing.
I work around food related, more of food related, like Fair Share is something that I support. Brighton Community Kitchen now, they've been doing a fantastic job. I don't know if they're on the show yet, but I think they should be on the show at some
point.
So we done a lesson to help them get a dishwasher there, and also always try and help with work with Butler's Wines because they support yes. Crew Club in White Hawk, which is a massive, massive cause actually. Yes. So
and
I'm there whenever
Henry
I can.
And Cassie on the show, and yeah. they are fabulous.
Yes, and whenever I could, I'll try and help them out. Mm-hmm. Apart from that, you know, back home, we helped building an old age home in Bangalore in mm-hmm. south of India, and done a couple of cooking lessons that help and support raise money for children with cancer UK.
Incredible, incredible work.
So whenever I get time, yeah.
do you sleep?
Yes, I do sleep very well, actually. I think it's all that satisfaction.
Yes, exactly. Yeah. Oh, you deserve to sleep. We are coming to the end. It has just flown by.
It's incredible, yeah.
So can you, with the Cook for Carola, can you remind our viewers where they can go if they want to eat some food and pay some money into
Right,
that?
I think we should start off with Pizza Face. Yeah. You can have your Carolan pizzas, inspired pizza, mm-hmm. or to Boho Gelato after that for a nice ice cream, or you can have a curry and then ice cream.
Yes.
So it's all a nice link, actually. Yeah. It's all a nice chain.
Have a course at each
yeah,
one.
Yeah, yeah,
brilliant.
Yeah. And then that's pretty much it for the moment, and we'll be planning more people joining
Excellent.
Us, and we'll be taking this much forward.
Well, Great. Please come back and see us very soon. We're coming up to our break. Thank you so much for coming
Thank
in.
You. Thank
it
you very
has
much.
Been absolutely brilliant to see you again. Thanks for coming back to see us. Please join us for more after the break. Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Assistant, if you want. If you want me to be Deb's assistant, then just message us on the Facebook page. Other assistants are available, like you know, Jason, Madeleine, Genevieve, so on.
Well, you're here,
Tori,
so I think
the wonderful Tori.
Well, you're here.
Wasn't Camphy really interesting?
He was really interesting.
I love what he's doing.
I really
doing.
Want to go on one of his tours.
Me too.
And I really want to eat lots of his food.
If you're interested, the tours are about 8 to 10 days, depending.
Yes.
Price range goes from 1,690 up to 3,160 or so. But remember the amount of money that's going back into the community.
Absolutely.
I so want to do these things. I'd love to.
I would love to go on one of those tours. And just so that our viewers are aware, my birthday is coming up.
What?
So if you would like to make some contribution.
Now, meanwhile, there's a lovely guest on with us the second half. What's the matter? Are you looking upset?
No, carry on. You introduce our guest.
I want to because, you know, no one cares about your birthday. She is from All to Love. It's like, are you pouting? Are you pouting?
How dare you?
It's Katie Finch. Katie Finch, come and save us.
Come and break this up.
Save me.
You've got
awkward.
It's us being nice to each other. You haven't walked into any awkwardness. Hello.
Hello.
Thank you so much for joining us. It's
You're
lovely
welcome.
To have you
Thanks
here.
For having me.
Yes, why are you here? Yeah.
Wow.
Or rather, why
here?
Would you like to be here? Because we're aware of things like your kitty cat yoga thing, but.
Yes.
We want to know about the All to One Love thing, is this right?
So I am a yoga teacher, but that's on the side. I started a business with my business partner, who's also a yoga teacher, called All to Love. So she published a book called The Fearless Life Guide about people who want to make changes in their life.
Yes.
Since we've come together, we've realised there's a lot of practical changes that I've been making in my life, such as becoming zero waste. So we've produced a couple of online courses, recently launched the Zenful Zero Waste course, and that's what I'm here talking about today.
Zenful.
The key part.
So zero waste isn't just about food. It's
Correct.
Not just about food waste. It is about having no waste, not wasting anything in our lives whatsoever.
Yeah, it's about being more mindful about our consuming. Mm-hmm. So whatever we're consuming, whatever it might be, thinking about where it's coming from and where it's going.
Mm-hmm.
So more of the concept of a circular economy. So rather than buying things constantly new and then throwing them out, mm-hmm. it's about thinking about our impact on the environment. Mm-hmm. So we've seen it everywhere recently, plastic free. Mm-hmm. You know, the David Attenborough stuff, it's been everywhere.
Yes.
But this is taking the concept a little further. It's not just about plastic, it's about how we consume things.
Mm-hmm.
And thinking about where is our waste going?
Oh, it's whole life.
Not just relying on someone else.
Okay.
I heard someone say something recently that really got me thinking. I think the quote was something along the lines of, nothing is ever thrown away.
It's got to go somewhere.
It's got to go somewhere. And that got me thinking, wow.
Yeah.
All of this waste, because I recycle, but I still do accumulate some non-recyclable waste. Mm-hmm. That, when I put that in the bin and the bin men take it, where's that going? What's that doing? What impact is that having? So the sense I'm getting from you is you want to minimise that impact. No,
more than minimise?
More than minimise.
Get it to zero?
The idea is that you get rid of that and you go a step further. So yes. Think about recycling.
Okay.
So right now we think when we put something in a recycling bin that it is recycled. Mm. Well, once you start digging into that, you find out there's certain things that have to have happened for it to be completely recycled.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So it's about being self-responsible. But the Zenful bit's key.
Yes.
Because already you can start to feel this like, oh my, what, you mean recycling isn't working? Oh my God, what, zero waste? How is that even possible?
I was so tense then, carry on.
Right, see, don't worry, it's going to be Zenful. Mm. So a year ago when I started kind of becoming more towards zero waste, I had a complete meltdown, stood in the supermarket looking around thinking, I can never eat again, clearly, because everything's in plastic.
Yes.
And so I realised that if you're going to make big changes in your life, it has to be Zenful, hence where Zenful Zero Waste came from.
Okay.
And it's about making sure you've got all the information you need to make the best decision for you. There is no right or wrong way. This is not me standing here going, you shouldn't have plastic, you shouldn't do this. It's about having all the information about recycling or about where things are going so you can make an informed decision. And the course is designed to give you that information so you don't have to stress out about it.
The thing that goes through my mind the most is, and not that I'm an over-pampered ninny or anything, is that I quite like having the roof over my head.
Yes.
And I do quite like eating occasionally.
Yes.
How big a life change would I have to make to become zero waste?
So this is the thing. So for me, the key is to do it step by step, little by little, so it doesn't feel like a change. What you don't want to do is stop living your life.
Okay.
This is not about becoming minimalistic, not buying things. I like shopping.
Yeah.
You know, I like to go and get things. I'm just more conscious of where I get these things from. But the course is set up so that you maybe make a change once a week.
Mm-hmm. Right.
Maybe you make, in 8 weeks, there's enough information to give you all of the information to go fully zero waste. But that might not be Zenful. So it's a personal journey.
Right.
You make changes as and when. The Zenful is the key bit. Without it, it's just a very stressful experience. Mm-hmm.
Does that mean I have to give up Jaffa cakes, though?
Well, potentially, but maybe that's one that you pick last. But what about making your own or finding somewhere where you could turn up with your Tupperware, get your own Jaffa cake? So on the way here, I got myself a wrap rather than getting foil and paper, which also still has to go somewhere.
Yeah.
I just took my own little box of Tupperware.
And there has been, I'm starting to notice coffee houses and cafes, they're encouraging you take your own cup.
Massively.
And you'll get a bit of money off as well. So
exactly.
We are being encouraged slowly but surely to create less waste.
Yeah.
But it's not about the sort of day-to-day consumables that we consume.
Yes.
What about sort of things like clothing, furniture?
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, yes.
Stuff,
good point.
You know, bigger things.
Yeah.
I mean, going zero waste to that, because I'm a big fan of upcycling. I'm a big fan. I mean, I get somebody else to do it for me. But I'm a big fan of
upcycling.
Saying there's a cabinet or something that may ordinarily get chucked out, but somebody
doing
coming along,
nice
doing
with
something,
it.
Recovering a seat, something like that. Is that part of the
So one of the weeks is dedicated to shopping, fashion and homeware.
Right.
And there's a lot of things, you talk about them as the R's, so repurposing things, repairing things.
Yes.
There's all these little workshops popping up around the place where you could take things like a TV to be repaired.
Brilliant.
Rather than buying things, and things are very often built nowadays to break, and then you throw them out and buy something new.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. There's been a new wave of people who are going, actually, no, we could repair it or repurpose it, you know, use it for something else, upcycling, making things look nice when they're maybe a little bit older.
Yeah.
And a lot of the stuff that you buy, if you buy vintage or the older stuff, it was built to last.
Yes. Yeah,
do you notice it? That is so true. And actually, some of the things that we buy in certain retail outlets nowadays, which are very cheap and cheerful, I've got stuff that's much, much older that I've bought in charity shops and vintage shops that's just outliving it tenfold.
Completely.
So it does make perfect sense.
Yeah.
And although I don't want to get personal, your stuff looks brilliant. I've seen some of the stuff.
Well, this is the thing. You get your own sense of style. You don't look like everyone else on the streets. Double win.
I have to ask this, though.
Yes.
How close to zero waste have you managed to achieve?
I would never say that I'm fully zero waste. I'm always quite clear about the intention is to go towards zero waste.
Okay, so that's...
I don't know if zero waste is actually legitimately possible, but getting as close to it and having that idea of, you know, a circular economy and not having to be perfect. You know, none of us are perfect, and you don't want it to be something that you beat yourself up over, hence the Zenful concept.
Right.
But I'm as close as possible. I'm as mindful as I can be, but I still want to enjoy my life. And so if I accidentally end up with a straw in my drink, I'm not going to cry my eyes out or flip the table. You know,
could be fun.
Could be funny, could be interesting.
But you know,
these things happen. Yeah, you take them home and use them. You know, you just make the best of the situation.
It sounds like a good attitude.
Clear intention.
I have to ask this other question, forgive me.
Yeah, of course.
Who pays for this? Now, I'm aware that you're charging somewhere around, what, $144 for the whole course. Actually, I think that's incredibly good value,
reasonable,
given the amount of information. You've given us a few tips and a taste of that.
Yeah.
Is it us, the consumer, what should we be paying for this? Should you be funded centrally to kind of come and...
Wouldn't that be ideal? I think...
What is the ideal?
At the moment, it's individuals who want to make a change, who aren't willing to wait for the government to make the changes, the businesses to make the changes. Wait until 2030 to go plastic-free for some people is too long. Mm-hmm. And so it's people stepping up and going, I want to make a change, but I'm not sure how to. And what we've tried to do is reward the people with discounts, with all these great zero-waste retailers who are working towards the same goal. So there's hundreds and hundreds of pounds worth of discounts.
Ooh.
If you do want to buy things, then you can.
So your fee's repaid in the savings?
Yeah, sounds like
as well as the good feeling.
As well as the good feeling, the fun, you build a community, you make friends doing the same thing, because I can be a bit lonely.
And they will pass that on to their friends, their families, their partners, their colleagues.
And it just shares.
And it will have this amazing ripple effect where we will look to really cutting down.
I'm loving this, I really am. And I think you've chosen the right republic to do this in.
Sure,
Brighton and Hove, you know, our lovely citizens
could
out
be
there.
Better.
Yeah, it couldn't be. So, best way of contacting you, we'll get a link up as well.
Yeah,
is it
great.
Is it web based?
Yeah, alltolove.com.
Yes.
If you want to check us out on Instagram, it's at alltolove. And my personal one is Katie Kit Kat Yoga. So I'm the financial director of alltolove, but most of our stuff goes on Katie Kit Kat Yoga and alltolove. But yeah,
Katie,
check us out on there.
Thank you very much indeed.
Thank you.
That's wonderful.
It's been really great to have you on. It's such an interesting thing to talk about.
Thank you.
Wish you the best of luck.
And thanks for joining us as well. Tune in again next week for the Social Society and Veronica Blacklace.